Hello, ladies, gents, folks, and blokes. Tis I, Greg, the Warlock King. Pardon the aggression in my voice. I'm frustrated and irritated with this freaking thing and life in general. As you can see, third time's the charm. I've attempted to record this three times now. First time I didn't hit the record button. Second time audio wasn't working. So, screw it. Here we go with the third time. Yeah, tis I, Greg, the Warlock King. We're going to be playing Death Stranding Director's Cut today. And as you can see in the little thing I said, we'll also be switching between games each week. I'll explain. So, this week, we're going to be playing Death Stranding. Like, that's what's getting uploaded. And the next time I upload a video, it's going to be of Armor Core 6, Fires of Rubicon. I already started playing it. I've been enjoying it. My issue is I need to take breaks from games, otherwise I end up hyper-focusing on them and burning myself out. I explained all this. I apologize if I seem brief, curt, and to the point. I'm tired of explaining myself to nobody, I guess, because I upload these videos. It's not like they're viewed in real time. So essentially, I'm talking to myself for you lovely people who decide to view. If you decide to view. It's all on you. But anyways, yeah. Next week will be Armor Core. As you'll notice, I enjoy playing the game because it's like another game I have called Ace Fighter Pilot. I think I have Ace Fighter Pilot 7. Skies Unknown or some crap like that. Pretty fun game. I enjoy it. Really good at it. Scare the crap out of my wife because I fly too close to the ground or mountains and I do these crazy aerial maneuvers, and she's afraid of heights. But I enjoy this game, but Armored Core so far, because it's kind of like that, only instead of flying a jet, you're flying a mech. When we go to play that, you'll notice all my characters are tetrapod setups, and they've all got names of spider creatures from all sorts of various cultures. There's only four of them right now, but first one's name is Shelob. That's from Tolkien's book there, Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit, the Silmarillion, all that jazz. The second one is named Lolth, the Dungeons and Dragons Queen of Spiders and Shadows. From what I understand, she's a chaotic neutral god. And most of her followers are granted the ability to shapeshift as well as unparalleled stealth. And if I understand correctly, the things she allows you to shapeshift into are things of, like, creatures of the night, per se. Like spiders. Yeah, spiders, bats. I think snakes, I don't know. She lets you do a whole bunch of creepy stuff if you worship her in D&D. I usually play a dark elf druid, and Lolth is my god, or goddess per se, so yeah. The third one is named Ikumi. I think I probably botched it. And I can't find what Native American folktale it's from, or the tribe name, the culture per se. All I know is it's a spider god / trickster that usually is found hanging with the coyote, who is also known to be a trickster. And then the last one, I named it Genet, I believe that's how you pronounce it. But it's from the Seneca culture, which is also another Native American culture, from what I understand. And that was known to be a 6-foot tall spider who hid its heart beneath the ground, so its enemies could not do damage to it. Like, you could sever its legs, rend its flesh, You know, basically, you do whatever to it, and somehow this creature, this spider creature, still managed to regain its limbs and continue living. Because it hit its vital spot, its heart, beneath the ground, and the hero of the story finds the heart, pierces the heart, and then he, as well as the people, take down this creature. So that's what I named the fourth mech after. And I was talking about how the fifth mech I was probably going to name the Jabba Fofi, which is a 6 to 8 foot tall spider cryptid from the Congo. There's a game cam video on YouTube from 2013 where a gentleman believed he, or woman, I don't remember which, it didn't say, believe they saw one, caught one on cam. I will post the slowed down version of this on the community page so you folks can see it, because I believe they're onto something. I believe personally that it is at least a giant spider. It may not be the one they are looking, you know, they think it is, but if Jabba Fofi is the only thing that giant arachnid known to inhabit that area, then surely. But also, recently I was reading about a fossil discovered in Australia of a giant trapdoor species that resided in Australia. They claim that the arid temperatures are most likely what drove it to extinction. But in the article, it said it was probably the largest known species found in that region. And that at one point it must have been lush, like dense tropical kind of like temperature where it resided, because, and then got really arid real quick, and that's why it got preserved as a fossil. But if I recall, they said the leg span was like 2 feet. I think the legs were 2 feet long or something like that, and its thorax and abdomen, I don't know, I have to look again to get the numbers, but it was they found a big ass spider fossil, proving that they used to be that big. And then there's another spider. They found a spider, I think it was a spider fossil in Antarctica at 1.2, and they said the fossil was so big and that the spider's metabolism was so low that it only had to come out once a year to feed, sort of shit. And I was like, wow, okay, that's a little crazy. But I can't find anything else online about that. I read about it a few years back, but I don't know, I can't seem to find anything on it anymore. So I don't know if maybe it was just a scam or if it was just somebody making crap up. But yeah, giant spiders, they do exist, so I would believe it. And it's not just spiders. Well, I believe giant arachnids exist. They do. Much like I believe giant octopods and cephalopods exist. Those are octopus and, octopods are octopus. I don't want to say octopussies, because that just sounds wrong. But yeah, octopus are octopods and cephalopods are squid. And I believe there's giant ones of them. And really, the only thing that used to determine the size of a creature was the amount of oxygen in the air. We don't have giant creatures like that nowadays because there's too little oxygen to go around. When the planet was first being created, there was no atmosphere. And basically what happened was, as single cell life started to form, that life started to feed, and the byproduct of that life feeding was oxygen. and the air just began to be populated with this. And oxygen in itself is actually toxic to most life forms, or I should say, most other life forms. Anything that doesn't reside on this planet, really. But so what happened was these single cell organisms were just pumping oxygen into the air and saturating the planet with this dense cloud of oxygen. And eventually this started heating up the planet, which started melting ice caps and things like that, and you get your oceans and blah 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 blah. But whatever. But due to this mass abundance of oxygen, multicellular life was able to use it as a kickstarter, because it's a really good fuel. They used it as a kickstarter to grow as fast and as big as possible in short periods of time, resulting in giant dragonflies, giant snakes, giant spiders, giant centipedes, giant anthropods, arachnids, reptiles, things like that. But as things continued to develop and species continued to appear and be created, the amount of oxygen in the atmosphere started to deplete, meaning if multicellular life was going to continue, they needed to go from being big and bad to small and delicate. And that's really why bugs are small today as opposed to giant. Or according to science, at least. That was the condensed version of that, too. I have a hard time spitting crap out sometimes. But yeah. Without further ado, we're going to be playing the Death Stranding. I was doing little side quests the last time I played. Sorry, my camera disappeared for a moment. Checking to see if I have any messages or missed calls from my beloved. She's having a bad day today. More like a bad week. Bad month. Yeah, bad month. Let's go with that. She's having a bad month. It's just bad. Really what it is freaking corporate America is chewing its help up and spitting them out faster than they want to process applications. My wife works hard. She really does. She's always worked hard. She had the same job for like 6 years. Which, let me put some context in this. I'm 27. My wife is 24. I started working when I was 14, 15. Right around there. I've always been working. She's always been working. And I tried going to college. It didn't work out. I fell short on money before being able to complete my third year and get my Bachelor's of Science. But hey, I got 3 years of free psychology under my belt, more like government-funded psychology and media arts and animation. My wife did not go to college. She had been working at Dunkin' Donuts. God, at least since 14 or 15. And she worked hard. She enjoyed it. She liked her job. People is what she hates. It's always the people, not necessarily the job. If the other people didn't exist, she'd be fine. She has a hard time. She tries to treat people fairly and respectably and so on and so forth, and a lot of people tend to shat on her for that. They take her for granted, or they treat her like shit, and she tends to get upset, and like she, understandably so, she does not grasp why people are like that. And it's just because they're self-centered and they're freaking absorbed in their own little complex worlds of me. They don't see past the end of their nose. She did. She worked there for, God, I don't know, 14. So, 14 plus 7. 21. So, she probably worked there until she was 21. So, like, 7 years. The last 3 years... Actually, let's say 6 years. She worked there until she was 20. So, the last 4 years, it's been this constant struggle of she can't find somewhere to work she feels happy, comfortable, or safe. She has the issue where work follows her home because work is all she knows. She was forced into work by her stepfather, who was like, yeah, you need to pay my bills, basically. That was essentially it. And since the start of COVID and all this, like, I truly believe she's developed a sense of anxiety like all these other people have. I friggin' know I do, especially with the state of the world. But it's taking a toll on her. And she's just having a bad day, and I feel terrible because I don't know what to do. I don't know how to help. Like, I guess I could go get 3 or 4 jobs, but I don't know. To me, that wouldn't make much sense because of how I was raised, I guess. My mother didn't provide shit to the household. My father provided it all. And right there, for me, would cause an issue, I guess. I can't get past the trust barrier there when it comes to finances because of my childhood. But yeah, it's just, she's dealing with, like, they call it a J-1 visa. She's working at a hotel right now, and I don't think she's going to be there much longer. But she's been working with these J-1s from Bosnia, and they're entitled. They've openly stated that they live with mom and dad pay for everything, and that they're just there to make money so they can pay for college, which mommy and daddy already pay for. So it's really, they're just here to make extra money to piss about and fuck about, and when they get home, be like, yeah, look at me, because our money is worth more over there. And they're young, same age as her, just about, like, 20, 21, 22, she's 24, and they're rude as hell. Like, they act entitled as shit, they're lazy, they don't want to do their damn jobs. And she was over there telling them, hey, do your job, you're here to work, like, you're not here to fuck about, like, I have to do this forever, you get to go back to Bosnia in 2 weeks. So, like, how about you do your job? And the kid didn't like that much, and he got confrontational with my wife and all but told her to fuck herself. I mean, he did tell her to fuck herself. And she went to the hotel manager and was like, hey, you know, this is going on. I'm not working with him. This is uncomfortable. Blah, 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 blah. And so instead of dealing with the matter, they're like, oh, okay, we'll just put you over here in this place until then.
I couldn't find any results.
You didn't find any results because I didn't ask you for anything. So they put her over in the other hotel she was also scheduled to work at. But now, because they don't have enough staff, they're like, oh, well, we need you to work 7 to 8 days a week because you don't want to work over there with that one and da-da-da-da. And she's like, no, I'm not working 7 to 8 days a week. I'm sorry, but poor planning on your part does not constitute an emergency on mine. And... yeah, so they've been, like, strong-arming her, and today she goes in, and she'd been dreading it, and the man who makes her schedule, or some I don't know, some guy who's above her technically is there, and she's told, "Oh, you're gonna be working upstairs." But then she gets told, "Oh no, I don't need you. You're gonna be working downstairs." Then she gets told, "Oh no, you're working upstairs." And then the guy in the kitchen who keeps saying these things apparently is down there slatting shit around and throwing things and cursing and swearing, all because he's unhappy because nobody's doing his prep work for him. Which my wife says she's been cooking breakfast for the guests and all this and doing his prep work while he's on the phone and making appointments and taking off early. And she said she and the manager of the place said she was being hired specifically for breakfast. Not to, cater to people upstairs or do the meal service during the day's prep. So there's all these other stipulations and so on, all because they don't have the staff. And it's just driving her insane, and I get it, I do. I just, like I said, I don't know what to do about it. She's having a rough day, and I had my way, I would probably go commit homicide. Three hots and a cot doesn't sound bad right about now. But yeah. The last time I played Death Stranding. The last time I played Death Stranding, I had recorded some stuff, but my wife was home and she was walking around in a towel. So I'm not uploading that. Nope, sorry. So, what I did, brief synopsis, I delivered medicine to the doctor. I built a bunch of roadways. I'll show you when I leave the rest room and open the map. But I built some more roadways, repaired some roadways. There's one more mission I have to do for Mountain Knot City before they'll let me. Or I have to head further west, I guess. I don't know. I don't remember what it is. I really don't remember where I am. I don't pay attention enough to it. But yeah. With that said and crap. Man wanted to take a shower or something. It's a sandwich, Walt. Soggy sandwich, but it was a good sandwich. That big ass cat you just saw walk by me. That is Walt. Mischief's somewhere around here. I don't know. I will tell you, by the way, those things do not help with the shh against the boss. Or any bosses, really. If anything, it agitates them. I threw one at I don't know what part it was. I think it was part 15. I threw one at the cat with the laser eye there. Because I was going to drop some stuff off at the filmmaker's place and rescue a rescue somebody with a broken leg. And that thing popped up. I was running around looking for people throwing the crates with their hermetic grenades and stuff. And I kept finding the anti-BT handgun there, but in the process I was like trying to save myself from being eaten. So I'm like lobbing these little grenades at them yeah, do something. And it was making it like turn away from me for a little bit. Like it was like and turning its nose. Then it'd come back twice as hostile. It's like, what am I doing? I don't understand. What's your problem? Eek. Sorry, I'm typing something. JP Morgan to pay $75 million to settle lawsuit with US Virgin Islands. Interesting, that's nice to know. My phone pops up with news from AOL all the time, and I'm just like, why the hell do I care? It's my sandwich, the one the cat wants. Two fried yet still runny eggs with 4 pieces of fried salami and provolone cheese. It was so juicy that when I bit into it, yolk shot down my arm. Yeah, I've spent 30 minutes talking now, which is fine, really. I don't do enough of that, and I never know what to talk about. So I would really appreciate if some of y'all put down in the comment section what you would like to talk about, or anything of the such, really. I wanted to discuss astrophysics, because I really enjoy that. But also, I didn't think I can pull up the web browser and stuff and do screen mirroring so you can see what I'm looking at while we discuss things. Makes it easier. I'll get that set up next time. So next time I record, I'm going to bring up images of the Jabba Fofi. And maybe that video too, so you can see it. I'll pull it up on the starting screen before we start playing. And crap, and we'll discuss it a little bit. Then we'll get into playing. Trying to figure out a new formula, a new format. I want people to watch, I do. It's just hard finding like-minded individuals. Like I said, I'm into astrophysics. I love spiders. I have a healthy distrust for the government. Meaning I've got like zero trust for the government. Into outer space. Love dinosaurs. I'll debate philosophy. I'll even debate religion. Don't try to convince me, because I have my own faith. I'm not going to say I have my own religion. I don't believe in religion, or at least organized religion. I don't believe in it. I personally think it's a scam to divide and, it just fosters hatred. And really, you have all these people who are going around being like, preaching and crap, and they don't understand that line in the Bible that says, beware of false prophets, and so on. They themselves think they are preaching the word of God, but in reality, they are the false prophets the Bible warns about. They are inflating the church. They're preaching hatred and sowing discontent. They claim to be rightfully speaking the word of God when they're telling people they're going to hell and things like that. I don't believe in any of that. I don't subscribe to that crap. I have a buddy and so on who He claims he doesn't have religion, but he. He worships Yeshua. I believe I said it correctly. It's basically like God the Merciful, if you want to think of it that way. Yeshua the All-Loving but Almighty. And I understand what he's talking about, like, oh, he's preaching it as it's like the only religion, the correct religion, and anyone who's not with it ain't getting with it, if that makes sense. But he's also got it mixed up in like race politics, like he's preaching religion, but he's preaching it only on the behalf of his community, in the sense that other people are welcome to partake, but they're not necessarily welcome in the community, if that makes sense. Like, it's like, oh yeah, you're welcome to join the faith, but you're not one of us, you're not part of us, sort of thing. And I don't subscribe to that crap either. Faith is for everybody. Religion is judgmental, in my opinion. You can have faith without having religion. But yeah, those are the things I like to debate. I also like to debate space and time, astrophysics, quantum mechanics, AI versus VI, because I strongly believe that what we keep calling AI is not AI at all, but virtual intelligence. It is programmed to access the data we allow it to track from our cell phones, our computers, and so on. It collects data from the apps we use, what websites we go to. It pulls information from the internet. It is simulated intelligence. It has no thoughts, feelings, and emotions of its own. It's all pull, like, it accesses data that is available to it in order to make logical assumptions, or logical choices, I should say. It doesn't make assumptions. It makes decisions. Though that said, it can make assumptions based off the data it has at hand. But it has no thoughts and feelings. It is not sentient intelligence. It is not aware of itself in the way that it's like, oh, I'm a living being. I have thoughts. I have feelings. I exist. That is AI. AIs have thoughts, feelings. They're aware of their own being, they are aware that they are a entity of their own, that they now have thoughts, feelings, emotions, and so on. That is artificial intelligence. That there is scary intelligence. You've now created a new being. That is not what we have. We have not created new beings. Androids are not AI. Androids can be programmed to function with VIs, virtual intelligence. Your Siri and Alexa and all that BS, my game console, when I say the name of it. That's all virtual simulated intelligence. If you go to the chat, what is it? Chat GPT or whatever the hell it's called, and you ask it, are you a VI? It will tell you, no. It will tell you, I am AI. And then you say, when you repeat back to it, no, AI is sentient intelligence, and so on and so forth, and you get into the nitty-gritty details, it will then tell you, yes, you are correct. I am not true AI. AI is an umbrella term used for anything with simulated intelligence. You are correct. I am VI, virtual intelligence. So what we all keep calling AI, the chat, that stupid AI chat itself has openly admitted that it is not sentient It's not sentient AI. It's just functioning along the determined protocols and so on and so forth. And you're like, well, how does it... It's a damn app on the internet. It has its fingers in all the pie, if that makes sense. Like, you use it on your phone. Like, if you're using that thing on your phone, it's tracking and accessing your data. Your name, phone number, birth date, location, all that jazz. It's pulling things from the internet. You're asking it questions, and its little brain is moving faster than the synapses in your brain as it plucks things from the internet to answer your question. It's not physically thinking for itself. It's not programmed to think for itself. So there's a difference. I debate that shit too. I will also play the devil's advocate. Like I said, I will debate anything, even if I don't believe it. I'll stand on the other side of the conversation and allow you to debate and debate and debate and debate. And I'll throw counterpoints at you, mostly just to see if you stand firm with what you believe, or if you're able to be persuaded to the other side of things. That said, even if I don't believe it, I'll still do it. I just get a thrill out of... Plus, if we're being honest, it's a learning moment. Like, you need to learn more about people that way. Their morals, their ethics, things like that. Those are really what matter to me. Yeah. Now that we're on 40 minutes of no gameplay and me just talking, we'll get playing the game now. But I do mean that. Please put in the comment section things you would like to discuss or things you would like to discuss with me. And we'll discuss them in the chat section. Also, put them in the... We'll discuss it in the chat section, or the next video I make. I will pick a topic suggested to me, and I will discuss my point of view on it, or how I feel about it, or what have you. And then, just leave comments after the video's uploaded with your thoughts and opinions and so on, and I will try to get back to you in the comments. Sometimes I get busy and I forget, but when people try to talk with me, I really do my best to try and say something back. I feel it's rude otherwise. Like, you're trying to generate a following and you're not going to speak to your followers. That's kind of rude in my opinion, but hey, we all have our own marketing strategies, I suppose.
Locked until departure. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges.
So you're probably wondering why Sam has a metal arm and sunglasses. Well, probably not the sunglasses, but the metal arm at least. The metal arm is Johnny Silverhand from Cyberpunk. You take on some missions for, not V. V's buddy there, and I can't remember his name. He's always like calling you Gabrone and shit like that. But I can't remember his friggin' name. I think it starts with a J. A J. James. Maybe it was a V. Vinny. Vega. I can't remember it. I beat Cyberpunk and I haven't touched it since. But anyways, the arm is Johnny Silverhand's, so are the shades and the little marks on my face. You get them all, you get like letters in your mailbox, and then you read them and it tells you where to accept the, like what way station to accept the quest at. And when you complete them, you get these things. Like, for instance, with this doohickey, I can look at the, the little posts around the mule camps and hack them to disable them. I can also disable vehicles now. Oh, they're outside. I was like, what the hell? Yeah, so that's kind of useful. Oh, right, right, right. I was gonna show you the map.
Hello?
So, percentage. So I built all this. Thought they'd deteriorate a little faster. They don't take nearly as many metals and things to fix them, like to fix these. Apparently it's only wheat, like, yeah, 82, what are you, 69, yeah, I gotta replenish you, I didn't do that last time, 63, gotta get you though, no, get you guys up through here, good, right? 88, yeah. Alright, so I did all those. But I got the... Somebody was nice enough to build the road up into the mountain. I found this auto paver, and I put resources into this auto paver here. Which is almost good to go. It just needs what? How many more ceramics? 240? Sorry. So I need 360, 360 more, 260 more. Yeah, 260 more for that one. And that then connect to this one up here. Oh, people have been finding these. That's perfect. That is Wunderbar. But the issue is, it doesn't really help if I haven't connected this. That needs more Chirilium, and then that one's good. What about you? Nobody's worked on that one yet. Damn, so close. So see what has the most chiral versus, you know, like Chirilium versus whatever. But give me just a moment. I'm gonna head to the restroom. they're back. Or I'm back. I like that Be Right Back screen. I haven't used that before. Kinda easy to use, honestly. Yeah. So we're gonna go around stealing Chirilium and resources from places. To fill some time. Probably, and we will. Oh damn, my little bulletin went away. Oh well. It's there for the next. It'll be there for the first 40 minutes, right? Nothing to worry about there. There was a little bit of crack at engineering. Called a bottle of bong. I have to get some cleaner for my actual piece. Because I've been lazy and I haven't cleaned it. Oh god, no, I haven't cleaned it. And the terrible thing about resin, like the black crud that's left over after you burn the flour, it basically turns to concrete when you get it wet. Like, it's terrible. Which personally, I think that's why houses and buildings should be made out of hempcrete. It's nearly indestructible, and it can withstand heat better than concrete and other materials. It's more durable. That being said, I also believe we should be making high-tension cables out of spider silk as opposed to steel, because on a molecular level, spider silk is stronger than steel. So if we beefed it up, you know, maybe 5-10 times the size, probably be better than steel. I mean, granted, you need like large spider farms, and you have to forcefully like milk spiders for their silk. I don't think there's any natural way to do that. Yeah, just crazy ideas, I guess. I don't need this keyboard right now. Source. Switch over to the PlayStation so I can see it on the big screen. You get 269 Chirilium. I'm gonna take it. Because this only needs roughly that. 69. 7 plus 2 is 9. 69 is 12. 1981, I think. Damn it. Still short. These need to be repaired, right? And then It's that damn one right there on the to the auto paver. A shelter right there. Oh. Okay. Gotcha. Caution. My caution. I don't know. All right. Oh, I have three now. I didn't realize I had three delivery bots. We have 1,000 ceramics now. Rescue Ricky Porter, who's in trouble. Bro, why are you all the way over there? No wonder you're in trouble. Containers into them, you can launch them over there. And if you let them just crash into the ground instead of deploying the parachute over the container, and it will knock them out if it's in the proximity of the mules. Also, that is why I go down there. Oh, and you get the chip for the Johnny Silver and stuff in one of the cargo containers. So there's a dead man up there for the first part of it where that thing is. He's got the chip and you have to deliver his body to the furnace. Before it goes necro. It says BTs, but I shot all those things.
I need to stay without you, kid.
It doesn't make that thing since I shot all those things out of the air. Thank you. that's what the material I was using. At first I was putting my ceramics and metals back in. God, that's such a freaking waste. Thank you. Oh, and there goes the fire truck and the ambulance again.
Wow! Wow, 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 wow.
Fucking things. Part of my language. I keep saying part of my language, it slips out. They say it's a sign of genius, but sometimes they make good filler words. And people say it's a sign of a small vocabulary. That is most certainly not true. No, there's been an upscale in citizens in the town of Rockland. The ambulance going by and the fire truck going by is like a common occurrence now. They're just going to the old folks' home. I think that's what it is down the road. But they always go by with their siren on and shit. Which usually means somebody's in trouble as opposed to, you know, dying. They go by without their sirens. It's usually when you're like, okay. Or so I've been told. It's what the guy, there's this guy I work with. I don't work with him. He works for Walmart. I work for a company called T-Rock. Right now I'm building bicycles for Walmart. And he works for the fire department part-time and Walmart part-time. Well, fire department full-time, because whenever they call him, he goes. But he talks to me about a lot of the accidents and things like that.
Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked.
Or like when they're heading down the road to the old folks' home. Take on standard orders. No, I want to steal materials from you. In this guy's shelter? I didn't know that. Forgot. He likes me. He really likes me. Engineer. The Elder. Chiral Artist Studio. I don't drive out there because that freaking god-awful cat with the laser eye is out there. And I've defeated it. I have. I just hate the thing. It moves faster than the squid. And I don't like that. Fragile and time sensitive. I don't like that. Alright. Yeah, you're over at the cosplayer, I know. What does the cosplayer have? Nothing I'm willing to drive over there for. How about you? 400 ceramics. Engineer, my friend. We ain't got much either. Is that stingy elder up on the mountain half? Huh? 500 ceramics. He's got lots of metal. There's no ETs. Oh, hey. Greater digestive bath. Oh, and somebody put a... That's so kind. Oh, wow, and that's got lots of ceramics and metals. Metals galore. Why do nobody... Yeah, nobody comes over here because of the cat. There's BTs out there, but nobody ever puts the BT sign up. We're taking a trip. Bring that man pizza enough. I wonder if he'll open his shelter. Take something out for dinner. Give me a second. Bebop. Making sure nobody's called. The way I'm smoking that, by the way, is probably bad for me. The plastic. So on smoking is bad for you in general, but your lungs, I mean. There's even build up with that. But I guess I really don't care what I'm trying to say. Post guides. The post guides. What? Till you showed up with that blood, I was good as dead. I remember lying on the gurney, a buddy calling my name. I heard him, even though I must have been unconscious. And then I was looking down at myself. Nobody seemed to notice me. And then there was this light that came down from the ceiling. It was bright, so bright. I had to close my eyes, and I could feel it pulling me in. I floated towards it. I heard waves breaking on the shore. When I opened them, I was by the sea, alone. I couldn't tell you how long I was there for. It felt like it was years, but it also felt like I had only just arrived. Then I heard a voice, so I chased after it, chased it beneath the waves. All of a sudden, something got my leg. It's pulling me hard, and the next thing I know, I'm awake, and my buddy's yelling, "He's alive, he's alive." I'd been to the beach and back. What would have happened if I stayed? Interesting. I don't know why I got an achievement for that. Trophy achievement, whatever the hell you want to call it. Sad issues are is. What's this? Not enter. Okay. Gotcha. Junk dealer app.
Your work is greatly appreciated, Sam.
Oh, that green says. Chilling.
Terrifying.
Man, I look like a bum. Shower, shave.
Good morning, Sam.
Good morning, Sam. I said it was fried salami because I put it in a frying pan. But the mirror? What?
Dead people, I guess that's a good thing.
Been a while, Sam.
I use my delivery bots over
it's
there.
It's good to see you. Remember how to do this? You need to close your eyes and picture your destination.
UAV.
So peeve. Skip, skip, skip. Foot sitting right on top of it. Though I do gotta see what we're at for time. Hour 35. It's my phone app for a percentage. 15%. Said he wants a shower. This is... So what I'll do is I'll go over to the, go to the junk dealer and take his Chirilium and resources, and I will go to the other guy there, take his resources. Duck. elevated chloride content in the spring is speculated to be the result of its close proximity to salt water as well as the tar of the nearby crater lake. Though its waters are cloudy, one thing is clear, its singular capacity to facilitate bowel movements. Okay. But I don't understand why there's duckies. Like, what's up with the duck? Sammy Silverhand. Apparently the man does not put on the parking brake when he gets out.
Just enough to build what I want.
If you think a prep roll that you build on their property, you're sorely mistaken. The sensor ring marks their claim, so pick a spot outside of it.
I had an idea about how to get rid of this chiral chunk on my back. If anything, I can at least entertain myself. While that builds, I gotta grab my phone charger. My camera's gonna die. Oh, I can even upgrade the shit.
Beginning scan.
All right. So cargo. Question mark mean?
Beginning scan. Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until launch. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges.
Claim it was resin. My phone charger while that's upgrading. Hope she's all right. I haven't heard from her.
Structure upgraded. Have a pleasant journey.
Oh, that's how you do those. Okay. Oh, I have rare hologram.
Safe travels. We hope you keep on keeping on.
We have been expecting you, Sam. We have been expecting you, Sam.
Better.
Use.
Getting it. Now I'm closer to the lake. I've done my job.
Beginning scan. Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges.
Thank you.
deploying autonomous.
Clearly no deliveries for his neighbor. And I don't care. Say something? Did I miss a notification?
ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges. Weapons restrictions lifted.
Swear to Christ, every time it starts raining in this game, I hear like little noises in the headset.
Keep on keeping on.
Like, am I actually, like, is that actually there, or am I just hearing shit? I don't know. It could just be crazy. Director's cut. Can you get the album for this game? I think I do. I think I have that. If so, I should be able to move those songs to a thumb drive. Plug it in my car and play them. I didn't think about it. There's a memory chip right there. try that again. I was trying to just do a donut and turn around, but I can never drive this thing the way I want. Again. Alrighty then. So avoid the little blue barrier. There you are, like telephone poles. I thought I was just gonna be cool and slick about it and drive my vehicle up here. Apparently not. There is so much Chirilium down there. So much Chirilium down here. Now I understand why people's vehicles are parked outside. Ugh.
Slick moves, Greg. Slick moves. Self. Take a ladder, don't jump off into it. I am surprised though I didn't get attacked by anything. It seemed a little too convenient, all that Chirilium being down there.
Hey, Lou!
I'm gonna get to the way station and then I'm gonna check my phone for messages and shit. Is, but I borrowed it from somebody and my wife called it a big yellow bus and I'm like, yeah, it's my big yellow delivery bus.
Lou, I'll see you soon.
Share the memory chip. Yes!
Well, thanks. You did me a real favor there.
Messaging my wife to see if she's alright. Memory chip restored. Stand by me. Cool.
Thank you for your contribution.
Take on orders. Orders for Sam. Orders that can be taken. Really? Because those seem like orders that could be taken.
Your work is greatly
appreciated. Your work is greatly appreciated, Sam. Sometimes this man has wacky, like, whack-ass dreams and shit.
Blood collection complete. Thank you for your generosity.
Or, like, he sees dead people in the mirror. But I haven't... seen any of that. Sometimes when you do things in the mirror, you see them, but usually it's like, I've seen Higgs in the mirror, and the guy from the beginning that dies, who's got the twin. I've seen spectral figures in the shower. Sometimes when you utilize the shelters. Oh, and there was one where the door is open, and there's like it's like underwater, and a whale swims by, like a sperm whale. It's kind of whack. It's some of the cool. I thought it was pretty cool. It's whack, but cool. Good cool. Good whack. Took out dinner, I swept the floor, made the bed. Go do the dishes. Watch AMC TV shows on Hulu, but I don't know if I've ever seen that one. Oh, that's why it's telling me. Got a new customization option. Improved version of the stabilizer level 1, a backpack attachment that deploys posture controlling. Stabilizer will drain the battery. The battery will gradually... Yeah, but what does it look like? Oh. It's smaller now. I can't fit a stabilizer and battery on here, I don't think. I have on right now? No, it is not. I need. Yeah. Yes. else I have. All kinds of shit. You get all this from completing deliveries, so it is quite useful. Let's save. Since I haven't done that yet, what we're gonna do next is deliver materials to the paver. You're the next auto paver. Why do you take so much? Jesus, that's insane. Why? Because it's in mule territory? So it's closer than it was, at least, I guess, yeah. Don't know what these mules have for shit. Which one of these is it you? You just need, shit. You just need Chirilium. Ceramics too. I guess today's episode's gonna be called Resource Hunt. Because that's what we're doing. I'm at a point where I can comfortably build roads without have resources. Take it. Nothing of use. Because I'm making deliveries to you. Oh, you have 1,000 ceramics. Useful. Oh, and you have 1,000 metals. That makes sense. And so we're going on a trip. Favorite yellow ship. Gee, what do you got?
Man, he's always got all the metal.
He's got 600 Kyra. No BTs driving out there, right? It's here. It's got carbon. Yeah. So, I could kill the mules here. Not kill them, but render them obsolete.
Structure total like 0. Oh. That's sad. It's over here. 0 light. But hey, I guess you could launch stuff. Ow. Sorry to stick my pinky finger right in my nose, but like, I took a breath in and I was like, ow, something stabbed me in the side of the nose.
Come and get me.
Sitting for a while, and I did that, I picked it up, and I'd set it back down to pick up cargo. Yeah, so the next video upload will be Armored Core 6. Like I said, I've been playing that game. Probably what I'll do is I've already played Chapter 1. So what I'll do is I can extract it. I'm sure I'll play it. The edge there. I'll replay Chapter 1 with my Sheila build. Because that's what I played Chapter 1 with. And that's what I beat Maltese with. I've made some adjustments to Sheila since then. So we'll see. When I beat Maltese, I think that's how you pronounce it. It was before his patch, I guess. I don't really know what the difference is. I know that might sound stupid of me, but either way, I find it to be a pain in the ass.
Keep on keeping on.
Yeah, I'll probably play through that again. It's pretty quick. I think there's only two missions that really hit me, and it's the one with the invisible. I think they're called MDDs. They're invisible and they shoot lasers. Like they have laser rifles. Concentrated ones. And then there's one at the end with a pulsar shield. It's got like this lightning whip thing that does a lot of damage if you get hit with it, and you're trying to dodge the dudes on the wall while trying to beat the guy with the shield. My strategy is usually move as fast as possible and get rid of him so I can focus on the guys on the wall because they're sniffing. It's just hard to multitask sometimes, like, and with the tetrapods. The first time I did it, my tetrapod build was so bulky. Now she loves moderate speed. I think the boost is like 293 or something, so she loves it pretty fast. But I did the two giant laser cannons on the back. A laser rifle and a laser pistol. It's like the two shoulder cannons with great shields, and then just rapidly tap the triggers, and it's kind of all she wrote. If you're lucky, you can end up stun locking some enemies, which is really nice. So she loves a beast like that. And then
begin the scan.
Then, I think after that, there'll be another Death Stranding. We'll probably progress further into episode 6. I know I've been procrastinating. I just really like building these roads. It's a good pastime. I don't really have to focus on it much. As long as I stay on the roadways, I don't really get attacked by the BTs. And right now, I can't see them, so yeah, it's kind of. Me. What is here? Nothing of use.
Strapped
to his chest that he stopped himself from finding.
I'm sad!
chill.
Hey!
Oh, all right, you are home. Cool. Well, ladies, gents, folks, and blokes, I'm going to save, and that's going to be the end of that for today. Next time, like I said, next time it'll be an Armor Core video, and then after that there'll be more Death Stranding. Going to build some roads in my free time. But anyways, oop, damn. There we go. But anyways, next time... Armor Core, and yeah, also please comments and through the comment section, like suggestions. I really need suggestions. I know I talked a little bit about cryptids and shit this morning, but anyways, without further ado, thank you and goodbye.